Hello everyone, in this short video I will introduce you guys to the new FX Delta 2, which brings many new features and options, and basically we try to put and bring FX Delta 1 to the next level. Now before we move on, I would like to thank everyone who sent us feedback and who suggested different ideas about options and services that could be added, how basically to make it better. So anyone, thank you guys, and especially for the beta testers who also did fantastic job here. All right, so let's begin and get to the actual stuff. Well, first thing in general, what we can say is that we brought the trading journal, which many traders, in my opinion, are for some reason not applying into their trading, and that's why having a trade journal, well, at least in theory, should make you a better trader, right? So what the journal does is basically you can enable it or disable it. It will give you entry and exit screenshots plus a text file containing all the data entries, basically, like what time was the trade opened, the symbol of the trade, entry price, exit price, etc., etc. So really, really useful stuff, especially for people who are trying to still learn in order to track your performance in a much more efficient way. I think you're going to appreciate this option. The next thing which falls into the general category is the multi-language support, and I'm really happy about that because we have plenty of people coming from different backgrounds. So currently what we support is of course English, French, Spanish and German, and right here you can see that we already have that implemented. So hopefully that would be helpful for the non-English speakers. The third major thing here is, as you can probably notice already from the scanner, that we have introduced a new type of signal. So in the first version, we only had two arrows, right? And those two arrows were representing whenever we had delta pattern and whenever we had a signal. In version 2, we're introducing the aggressive signals, and that now gives us in total 3 arrows. And I think this is pretty self-explanatory what it means. That means twice more signals, at least. I'm not going to reveal exactly how this thing works yet. For those of you who can guess, well done, but I'm not going to dig deeper. After all, this video is meant to be just introduction to the new features. Next, we have active flag for running trades, and let me just try to show you how this works. We're going to open one trade very quickly, and you can see now this little dot which is going to appear right next to the arrows, and this is basically telling you that for this specific asset in this combination of time frames you have a running trade at the moment. I really find this feature very, very nice, because this way you can manage better your exposure, and once you see too many dots on the chart, maybe you're overexposing already. So really cool visual feature here. Then let's move on to the dashboard, where many, many things are actually being added. So the first thing that you're going to notice is, first of all, the visuals. The dashboard that we had before down here is now placed on the left hand side. I believe this is going to save us space because usually this part of the screen is less used. You can also see that we have transparency, which adds some Again, cool visual effects, but to the more serious stuff, we are now introducing the new quality filter. This filter is basically going to tell you whether the delta pattern on the higher time frame is of quality A or B, and of course, if quality A, that means it's better. So we have another way to automatically filter more or less the higher time frames delta pattern. You also see the newly introduced inner dashboard here, which is meant to simplify our trading when it comes to multiple assets. Basically, in the old version, it was somewhat confusing, and that was one of the main questions I usually got. So I've decided to create this thing. What we see here is a tiny table representing the time frames, and in the middle part here, you're going to see arrows up or down. These arrows will tell you whether you have delta pattern, bullish or bearish delta pattern on the corresponding time frame. And the dot that you see on the last part is basically going to tell you that, let's say currently we are on the 30-minute chart. So what we're working with at the moment is this one. All right, the combination that we're using is the 30-minute chart along with the 4-hour chart. This is also super interesting and valuable in my opinion, because if you have, as we saw many times, different arrows on the different time frames, it means we have different directions which are not synchronized between each other. So just scanning this thing really quickly, you can identify the current time frame that you're at, what combination of time frames you're using, and whether you have anything against or supporting your current direction, right? So again, I think this is useful, and many people will find it useful as well. We also have, as you can see, the built-in Fibonacci levels, and these levels are based on the delta top and the delta bottom, which is also a new feature. So these lines here and this information is basically going to tell us, okay, on the 4-hour chart, we have a bearish delta pattern. This is the top of the pattern, and this is the bottom of the pattern along with the prices. And when you place the Fibos right here, you will see that this is actually the levels built in right here, right? So this is what we have as well. That's best used, of course, for entries. It gives us the optimal levels in terms of Fibonacci levels, starting, of course, and using the three most used by traders, the 38, the 50, and the 61.8. So another fantastic feature here. We introduced the reset button, which basically means if you're doing some analysis and you put some objects here, once you click this thing, all this is going to be reset, and we're going to get the original template as set for the scanner. We also introduce a shortcut button which brings us back to the scanner. So once you click this button, you're automatically brought to the scanner, right? And another thing really useful here is the introduction of the news. So we're going to see news right here if anything is coming, and we're going to see vertical line on the chart whenever the news will meet the current price. So that's pretty much in general, guys, without going into too much detail here. Those are the new features that we have in Delta. For further details, of course, we're going to have webinars, and we're going to cover it in depth. Thank you for watching.